you do not need the new iPhone. With the launch prices of iPhones just skyrocketing over the past few years, I thought it would be a good idea to remind you all of why you don't even need to buy the newest iPhone. And hopefully this will help you make a decision to not buy the newest iPhone and maybe either wait another year, or if you really needed a new phone, buy an older model because it'll work just as well. Number one, the main features and improvements are actually more hardware based, and that's always been the case for a while now. But you won't really get to take advantage of these improvements because most people use their phones for their software capabilities. Either you're using it for content consumption like YouTube or Netflix, or you're taking down notes, or you're checking emails, or you're on social media. And it's not like something like TikTok will run so much faster on an iPhone 13 versus what I have here, which is my iPhone SE. It's just as good or bad, depending on the way that you look at it. The companies that run these apps want to make sure that their app runs well for as many people as possible, and so they would not be incentivized to slow it down or make it the best for the latest iPhone and then suddenly leave everything behind. That's why it still runs on phones like these. Number two, a lot of people are getting this for the camera, and trust me when I say you won't really be able to push your phone to the limit and maximize these features unless you actually knew what you were doing. Either you're an enthusiast photographer or videographer, or the best that I've seen are actual professionals who just prefer this form factor, but they still apply those principles that they apply to much more expensive cameras. If you can't take good photos with your iPhone 10, what makes you think that you can take good photos with an iPhone 13? A lot of what makes a good photo isn't really in the camera itself nowadays, especially with how good smartphone cameras have gotten. It's actually more to do with the person using it. And there have been actual feature films, I think one of them was even released on Netflix, that were shot on an iPhone 8. So really, if you were wanting to use a smartphone as a photography tool most of the time, a lot has been done with the older smartphones. And maybe if you feel like you're getting stuck and you're blaming the hardware, maybe it actually means that you just need to study up a bit more and practice a bit more on the smartphone you have today. The other hardware features that usually come with a new iPhone release is probably either a higher refresh rate screen or a higher resolution screen or smaller bezels. And I think the iPhone 13 features all three of these. Now, I would just want you to ask yourself, how much does a high refresh rate screen or a higher resolution screen or smaller bezels actually impact your overall smartphone usage and happiness? Because the answer for me is very, very little, because I don't really care about those things and I wouldn't really benefit from just having a smoother scrolling experience, which is what people seem to associate with higher refresh rate screens anyway. Reason number three, you can always buy an older iPhone model at a huge discount compared to what you could buy it new. The iPhone value proposition has really, really changed over the past few years. I remember a few years ago, there was a huge scandal where Apple was caught intentionally slowing down its devices. They claim it's for battery health, but we know that that also had the effect of people just switching to the newer iPhone. Now since then, which was around 2017, iPhone longevity has just gotten so much better. And this device I have here is proof of that, where I'm using the first generation iPhone SE from 2016, and it is still perfectly usable. Is it blazing fast? No, but it's not as bad as when I got an iPhone 4S around 3 years after release date. Actually, this is my first iPhone 4S and I still have it in my drawer for some reason. I got this back in 2014 and I remember that when I got it, I had so much regret because it was so slow, even though it was only 2 years past its original manufacture date. I still love this form factor, but the software was so bad on it that I just had to switch because it was just unusable. A stark contrast to the iPhone SE 2016 of today, which still works fine and is fully supported 5 years after its release date. And that's where the value proposition of an iPhone's really changed, because now you can buy a phone that's 2-3 years after its release date, say an iPhone 10 or an iPhone 10R, and still expect that you might get another 2-3 years of use afterwards. And that puts Apple iPhones, I guess, in the same league as budget Android price-wise, but so much better from a longevity point of view. And the final reason why you don't need the newest iPhone 13 is you probably need to get off your smartphone anyway. A newer smartphone will just tempt you to use it a lot more and enjoy its supposed new features, but in reality, we should all be trying to work to reduce our overall smartphone usage. Smartphone usage has drastically increased over time, and with the advent of new, more addictive apps like TikTok, and tech companies being better and better at manipulating human psychology. Like, there's a recent report about Facebook supposedly knowing that their products can be harmful to teenagers. And now the conundrum, obviously, is that that will also be what makes them money. We all should probably take a more conscious approach to limiting our smartphone usage. And that's where I found that using a much older phone does help a little bit there, because it's a bit slower, it's not as feature-packed, but it still gets all the basics done. And that's good enough for me. Hopefully, it will be good enough for you. Now, I did make a video about my current phone, which is a first-gen iPhone SE. If you want to see that, click on this end screen right here. I'll see you later. Bye.